first, I would like to thank everyone for watching my talk. So, yeah, thank you and welcome to my talk. During my talk, I will tell you something about the research I did in the past 14 weeks. As my topic, I chose the ocean. Since I was a little child, I already loved the ocean. I went on vacations with my parents to Greece and to Egypt, where I first saw the ocean and its beauty. I learned how to snorkel and saw the beautiful coral reef and a beautiful fish. But then when I turned 12, I also went on vacation to Australia and I got to see the Great Barrier Reef. It was at that point I knew I wanted to tribute to the ocean in one way or another. So here I am, 7 years later, studying event management and having the possibility to give something back to the ocean. I started my research to find problems that lay within the ocean, and the first problem I found was the plastic problem. But the odd thing about that is that Google only shows the plastic problem. When you ask for the pictures, when you type in problems within the ocean, you only see pictures of plastic problems and ships getting the plastic out of the ocean. And also when I tell people I'm doing research on the ocean, they immediately expect that I am researching the plastic. But the ocean is so big, the plastic is not the only problem within. So during my research, I tried to give a clear overview on what the 8 biggest problems were within the ocean. At first, I would like to tell you something about the shark fin problem. Every year, 73 million sharks are being killed because of their fins. Most of the sharks get brought on board of the ship and the fins are being cut off, and eventually the sharks will be thrown back in the sea without their fins. When the sharks, of course, have no chance of surviving anymore, and they will be eaten by the other marine life. In the past 50 years, we lost 80% of all our sharks. Sharks have a low reproductive rate and grow slowly, which means if we keep on going like this, there will be no sharks left. The second problem I would like to address is the acidifying of the ocean. Normally, seawater is basic, which means it has a pH degree higher than 7. But now, with the high amount of CO2 that is in the air, 1/4 of that ends up in the ocean. Which means the ocean gets more acidic. And so its pH degree becomes lower than 7. Because of the acidifying of the ocean will become acidic. And this means that the coral reefs will be destroyed. The coral reefs are not only very beautiful, they are also the home of a lot of fish. Which means that if we destroy the coral reefs, the fish also do not have a home anymore, and they eventually die. Another problem is that some animals in the ocean are made out of lime skeletons, and because the ocean is too acid, these lime skeletons cannot grow properly anymore. So animals like the plankton cannot grow properly anymore. The third problem I would like to tell you something about are the dead zones. Inside our ocean, there are areas without any oxygen in it, and these parts are called dead zones. An example of this is in the Mexico Gulf. The Mississippi River ends up in the Mexico Gulf, and the Mississippi River has a lot of pollution in it, so this all ends up in the Mexico Gulf. The Mexico Gulf gets polluted with a lot of nitrogen, and the algae that live there can feed themselves with that. So that means that the algae can grow very fast. And the negative thing about this is that they also have to die eventually. And in that process, when they die, they use a lot of oxygen. So they suck out the oxygen that is on the bottom of the ocean. And this is how dead zones are created. The fish that live there either can fly away or they die. But when they have to go to another part of the ocean, this is already occupied by other fish. So, one way or another, there is a problem. As you can imagine, this has a lot of influence on the ocean, but also on us, humans. One animal that is made out of the lime skeletons is the phytoplankton. The phytoplankton may be a small animal, but it produces 50 to 70% of the oxygen of our Earth. So, this means if we keep acidifying the ocean, we put one of the most important sources on Earth under pressure. So it is not only the ocean that has no oxygen left anymore. Eventually, we, humans, also have no oxygen left anymore. The saddest part of this whole story is that the cause of all the 8 problems are the same. In the end, we are the cause. We, humans, cause these problems within the ocean. So like I mentioned, not only the ocean is doomed by this, eventually we will take down ourselves. About 30 years ago, James Lovelock created his Gaia theory. It's called Gaia because Gaia is the mother of Earth according to the Greek mythology. According to the Gaia theory, the Earth is a self-regulating system that creates favorable conditions to keep the Earth alive. One of the models James Lovelock used was the Daisy World. The Daisy World is very simple. There are two things on the planet, the white daisies and the black daisies. The black daisies work with the sun, so they heat the Earth, so this is a positive feedback. The white daisies work against the sun because they reflect the sunlight and they cool down the planet. In this world, there's a stable environment despite all the changes that have happened. But now there's our world. And one big difference is that we, humans, are there. As I mentioned before, according to the Gaia theory, the Earth will do whatever it takes to get in her favorable conditions. So this means if she has to wipe out someone or something, she will do it. So for example, the coronavirus, when you look at it according to the Gaia theory, she did it because humans were no good for the planet and she was trying to get rid of it. I know I'm not the first one who finds out that there are terrible things happening to our ocean and our planet. Different organizations are already trying to help our planet. The Great Barrier Reef Foundation is trying to restore its coral. The Sea Shepherds are trying to protect the whales and the sharks. And the World Wildlife Fund is trying to help all the animals on the planet. But one thing I found out after my research is that we, humans, think we stand above all the other species in life. So I tried to come up with an idea that is also attractive for people who only care about themselves. How nice would it be if we could use leisure activities, not only to make sure we spend our time well, but leisure activities that would also benefit to our planet. So my question for my next research is, how can we use leisure activities to help people see that they are not the most important species in life? I want to thank you for listening. And I hope that the next time you see some coral or you see sharks, you remember what I said. Thank you. Now.